Good morning, it's 5 October 2012. I have been trying to remove the reflection from my glasses over the past 10 minutes. I feel frustrated. I can't change it. Over the past months, I made videos about the International Criminal Court. The fact that I, as a Dutch person, started a law case against the Netherlands within the International Criminal Court. But in the years before, I emailed presidents, ambassadors, royal families, the media, organizations. It's because of what I have been doing, I want to make a very clear statement today about Iran and Turkey, based on the psychology I have met over the past years. I want to emphasize that the politicians in Turkey and the politicians in Iran both want a civil war. Iran is in a very dangerous situation. The wealthy people of Iran have left the country, their residence in Dubai. They have taken their assets with them to Dubai, in either real estate investments or businesses or cash money. So the money is leaving Iran. Then the middle class and the poor are left behind, and they now need to fight for bread, water, clothes and money to pay the rent or the mortgage. I sit here with a very complicated, painful feeling. Oh, I shouldn't have said that. Now I start to cry. You know, I am watching war making for over the past 5 years. I know that Iran will end up in a civil war while it's absolutely not needed. It could have been prevented from taking place. And I have said it 100 times. I have said it 1,000 times in my emails over the past years, in my videos over the past months. So it's very painful for me to explain something I have already explained, knowing that perhaps a handful of people will listen and start to work with it, watch civilizations be demolished, watch planet Earth grow into one big war zone. But I do continue to make videos, because even when only a few people take them up, it starts to have some results. For example, I said it before, Al Jazeera has made a video about ICC, it's also linked on my website, that's really realistic about the racial and the partial methods of work of ICC. There are only a handful of professors, law or researchers or reporters who tell the truth about ICC, and unfortunately it's not enough, and those people have to bring the nasty truth to the same ugly painful truth like I bring it here today. The number of persons who want ICC to be a fair court system and who want to stop the misuse of power of the UN is too small. So I don't think that I or the other group of people will be in time to stop the growing numbers of civil wars. Ahmadinejad can stop the civil war today. It's really Ahmadinejad. And it's the fact that the Muslim world does want the money from the West, the businesses from the West, sometimes even the lifestyle from the West, but they don't want to build the legal obligations that come with it. They don't want to use the Western laws, the human rights treaties, and the Western court systems. That goes for Turkey too. Turkey is in a very dangerous situation too, for another reason. T- Turkey should have gone to the International Court of Justice after Syria had shot down a helicopter and killed two Turkish pilots. I explained that in another video. Turkey never did it. But Turkey should have gone to ICC to set an example, to calm the people's mind down. You know, if nobody goes to court, the people's mind will never be calmed down. If it becomes normal that presidents, ambassadors, political advisors, etc. go to court, we don't have civil wars. When Turkey would have gone to court after Syria has shot down the helicopter, we would not have such a violent explosion of copy terrorists today, because the people would have talked about it. They would have talked about going to court. And the same goes for countries around the border of Syria. They all are now being confronted with angry people, with refugees, with lack of food, lack of water, lack of medication. And they all have created the same ongoing civil war problem planet Earth has dealt with over the past decades. It are the politicians who create the civil wars and the refugee camps and the lack of goods and services we need. The countries around Syria could have gone to ICJ too, the International Court of Justice, and demand that Syria explains how they are going to take care of border security or refugees. But none of the countries did. None of the countries made Syria work with human rights or made Syria work with the UN Charter as presidents and the UN are supposed to work with it. Turkey has to start a law case against Syria today within the International Court of Justice. But they don't do it. They go to the UN Security Council. And within the UN Security Council, politicians behave like a herd of idiots, performing the same theater plays, years after years after years after years. They skip all their legal obligations entered in the UN Charter. They refuse to go to court systems to anticipate on the outbreak of conflicts, and then they turn to the UN Security Council, where a classical group of people come up with the same time of revolutions. NATO and Turkish politicians say in the media that they don't want war. Well, that's a lie. When they skip the International Court of Justice and they go to the UN Security Council for a bullshit revolution, they want war. And what worries me most is that the people start to become frightened and start to protest. When the people in Turkey protest against their government, that will create more copy terrorists. They shouldn't do that. The people should stay calm and should build a court case in Turkey against Turkish politicians for a Turkish court system. And they should demand that politicians work with the UN Charter and the human rights treaties in Turkey before the strange Turkish law is conducted, the law that says that it's okay for Turkey to attack a neighbor country for 1 year, that's not war, that's self-defense. No, that's war. When you go to the UN Charter, that's war. Turkey may not have a law, a national law that says we can have a mini war at the border for 1 year for our self-defense. Because they are part of the UN. And they have to take the UN Charter and go to the International Court of Justice to make sure that they are not in conflict with another country. And only when that fails, they can start to defend themselves. And now it's the other way around. Now they say, you know, we are in a conflict, we can skip the International Court of Justice and we start to bomb and kill immediately. Well, that's why we have all those wars. This specific behavior of politicians is why we have all those wars. They skip their legal obligations. I have been emailing Turkey too, because we have Geert Wilders in the Netherlands. And he is minimalized now, but he still is a war criminal, like all the other politicians we have. And my concern is at the moment that it's already 5 weeks ago I started the complaint, the letter of complaint. I started the complaint procedure within the International Criminal Court with my letter of complaint of 1 September 2012. As a response to the letter of 22 August 2012 I received from ICC. It's 5 weeks, and in 5 weeks many people have died needlessly. And now people turn to the street in Turkey and in Tehran, Iran, both for different reasons. I understand that. But it's both war, and in both situations people die, and in both situations it's already out of hands. And the signs I have here is that the International Criminal Court has absolutely no intentions, no plans to start to work with transparent procedures. Procedures that are available in every European court system, that are known to the people, or the people can look into it, can find the procedures. ICC refuses to do that. In 2008, they did not have a complaint procedure for victims who started law cases within ICC and are being tortured and killed by ICC employees. Now, in 2012, they apparently don't have a complaint procedure either. It's 4 years ahead, people. And in those 4 years, they could have copied a complaint procedure of at least 20 civilized court systems in Europe. They could have implemented 20 complaint procedures, but they refused to do so. So ICC has no intention at all to work like a court system. And they're not going to. I have to win this battle, and I feel demolished, more demolished every day, because I'm only here with a handful of other persons worldwide trying to clean up the mess, trying to stop the idiotic behavior of politicians. What needs to be done now? Well, I hope some young Turkish people and Iranian people will watch my video, and they will realize that they must not protest on the street, because protest is the end of your country. What you need to do is take your national laws, take the UN Charter, take the human rights treaties, take pen and paper, write letters to politicians, give them a time limit of 6 weeks. They must respond within 6 weeks. Write that in your letter. If they don't respond within 6 weeks and they don't give you your human rights, you have to do as you have described in your letter. You have to go to court against those politicians for misconduct, for crimes against humanity. And you have to get, you have that announced to the politicians in week 7. You have to send them, write them a second letter in week 7. And in that letter you state that you find the politicians guilty of violations of human rights in your own country, of violating the UN Charter, because they don't go to the International Court of Justice, and that you start a law case within your own Supreme Court or your Constitutional Court, as you name it. What you demand when you, as a young Iranian person or a young Turkish person, is that you want politicians to admit and to work with the UN Charter and go to the International Court of Justice for conflict ending. And only if that's not effective, they go to the UN Security Council. And only if that's not effective, they go to the International Criminal Court. So, I think I have said it correctly. I will watch this video tomorrow again. So people in Turkey and Iran must demand that their politicians work with the UN Charter. That's the most important thing to do. And that they don't start wars, but go to the International Court of Justice. Will that end your conflict? No, but it will calm the people down. It's so important that people take to the street and talk about justice with law books in their hands and with pen and paper in their hands to write the correct letters and to find the right court systems locally. The Kremlin still doesn't respond. Michael Prokhorov didn't respond. The Kremlin is, well, this is more than annoyance. You know, I have given them a very easy way out. They have enough people, enough money. Portugal doesn't. Jordan doesn't. David Cameron, well, Buckingham Palace is a war criminal family. They still don't do anything to clean up the International Criminal Court. They are silent after my videos and emails, but they don't do anything to help me. People are too passive. And they have too low self-esteem. They don't think that they can end conflict with pen and paper. Yes, you can. And you can make videos like I make. You know, the people have fallen into a trap. The trap of the social media. The followers of my website understand that I'm not on Twitter, Facebook, Hives, or all the other social media. And that's for a reason. First of all, I have to do everything by myself, you know. I don't want to spend my day using the social media. I really need to sit down and think, and I need to watch videos and documentaries, and the information we receive in the Dutch media is low standard and is minimalized. So I have to make an effort. I have to go to broadcasters like Al Jazeera and see for myself what the Dutch media has left out. This is work. I have to do some work. It's not only waking up, making a video, oh hi people, and that's it. That's it. No. I have to do some work. And I don't want that work to be turned into fantasy stories, because I try to cut down on fantasy stories. I try to be a woman, a human being, in the middle of hell, in the middle of too many fantasy stories, in the middle of too much aggression on the internet, on TV, and I try to be a normal, civilized thing that is in contact with other normal, civilized people or things. So It would be such a good method for especially people who are now in civil war or are very much afraid of being in civil war next week, to do something like I do. Don't express your panic on Twitter or Facebook. Don't express your grief on Facebook. But try to share the system you need to build for yourself in order to survive with the world. And you know that many wealthy people from Iran have moved to Dubai. In Dubai they all have luxurious apartments, laptops, and they can make videos. They can explain to the world themselves what needs to be done. They don't need to wait for the regular media. And that's what people have to do. They have to rebuild systems from the inside with pen and paper and law books, but also from the outside with pen, paper, law books and laptops. I can't tell you how nervous I am for the next Nobel Prize. If the Nobel Prize goes to the wrong people, goes to a president or ambassador or a political advisor or the wrong professor at the wrong university, oh, for God's sake. No. Well, it's it. I can only repeat myself, you know. Demand that your local politicians work with the UN Charter and go to the International Court of Justice before they go to the UN Security Council. And even now you are on the edge of a civil war, they can still go to ICG to clean up war zone, to clean up their own mess. Good luck to you. And stay calm. Don't kill your neighbors. I want to kill about 500 people. I don't do it. Don't kill your neighbors.